In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, God's good people. Today is Tuesday, the 21st of July, 2020, and you are listening to Catholic Meditation with me, Father Blessed. The Church celebrates the Feast of Saint Lawrence of Brindisi, priest and doctor of the Church. You are welcome. And thanks for joining us. Let us pray. O God, who for the glory of your name and the salvation of souls, bestowed on the priest Saint Lawrence of Brindisi a spirit of counsel and fortitude, grant, we pray, that in the same spirit we may know what must be done and through his intercession bring it to completion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. The first reading is taken from the prophet Micah, chapter 7, verses 14 to 15 and verses 18 to 20. The Gospel from St. Matthew, chapter 12, verses 46 to 50. I read from the first reading. Shepherd your people, Lord, with your staff, the flock of your inheritance, who dwell alone in a forest in the midst of a garden land. Let them feed in Bashan and Gilead as in the days of old. As in the days when you came out of the land of Egypt, I will show them marvelous things. Who is a God like you, pardoning iniquity and passing over transgression for the remnant of his inheritance? He does not retain his anger forever, because he delights in mercy. He will again have compassion upon us. He will tread our iniquities underfoot. You will cast all our sins into the depths of the sea. You will show faithfulness to Jacob and mercy to Abraham, as you have sworn to our fathers from the days of old. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Your eye is on the sparrow, and your hand it comforts me. From the ends of the earth to the depth of
God wants to use you as an instrument for positive change. God wants to use you as an instrument for positive change. Dearly beloved, today's meditation is drawn from the first reading taken from the prophet Micah. He is one of the 12 minor prophets. He was born in the year 740 BC and was the contemporary of the prophets Isaiah, Amos, and Hosea. He received his calling as a prophet in Jerusalem at the time when bad kings such as Ahaz were on the throne. He addressed his message to such wicked leaders and spoke out against the oppression of the people by both spiritual and secular leaders. Leaders who, rather than care for the people, oppressed them. They used their evil to smash the people, and that evil led to the ruin of Jerusalem. From this background, we can beautifully situate today's first reading. The prophet addresses the people and brings words of consolation. Since the leaders have failed, God himself will take charge of leading his people. The prophet assures the people that there is none like our God, and his leadership and governance can be compared to no other. The people can be consoled because God himself will do the work of shepherding the flock. With a shepherd's crook, God will lead the people to pasture. They will graze in Bashan and Gilead. Bashan and Gilead were the most fertile parts of the land because they were situated near the Jordan River. This image pictures Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. He will lead me to greener pastures and through restful waters to revive my drooping spirit. And even if I were to walk through the shadow of death, no evil would I fear, because the Lord is always there by my side. In this reading, the prophet Micah brings out two great qualities of God. First, he is a shepherd. And second, not only is he a shepherd, he is a merciful shepherd. As a shepherd, God is a leader. He cares and he provides. He knows the needs of his people and he will provide for them. He leads them to prosperity, as pictured by the land of Bashan and Gilead, to where there is fertility, to where there is prosperity. As a merciful father, God pardons and shows mercy. He has no anger. He shows faithful love and has pity. The psalm of today's liturgy, Psalm 85, explains these qualities when the psalmist says, God takes away the guilt of his people and blots out their sin. He retracts his anger and renounces the heat of his fury. God will not be angry forever. He will show us his faithful love. Beloved, this is very consoling to hear. We long for such leadership, where the shepherd has a gentle heart, where the shepherd cares and provides for the flock, especially when we contrast this image with the reality we live in. Egoism, self-centeredness, tyranny, dictatorship, and leaders who care more about themselves and are not merciful to their people, but rather lead them to suffering and pain. But not so for God, the prophet Micah says. He is that leader who is different, much different. He shows it when in today's gospel, Jesus says his mother, his brothers and sisters, in fact, his family is all inclusive. He cares for all. He is worried about all, and he embraces all. His family is not only blood related. He does not care only for his friends and associates, but for all those who listen and do his will. Now, how can we relate these readings to our daily lives? We have to do so by asking ourselves a question. How does God intend to lead us? How can God shepherd us in this way as presented by the prophet Micah? Beloved of God, God cannot appear on earth. He needs us to effect all this. He needs you and he needs me. We have to be the hands and the feet of God on earth. He needs you to effect the positive change that we all need and that we are talking about. Wherever you find yourself, in whatever you do, know that God wants you to act like him, to be that shepherd, to bring joy to those to whom you render service. You can be that leader he needs, who will shepherd his people with love, with care, who will be very forgiving, who will be all welcoming, everywhere you are and everywhere you find yourself. The temptation is, often, we like to look at government. True, they have their own responsibilities. But wherever we find ourselves, we too have to act in the way that God expects. In the family, as the head of the family, are you sure you bring joy to your wife, to your children? Do you care and do you provide for them? But you see, how often many times the heads of the families do not do their duty, but it is easy always to point fingers at others. Yes, even in that school where you find yourself, as the leader of the school, do you bring joy, happiness? Are you ready to forgive? Are you all welcoming, or do you select just a few? In that office where you sit, do you bring joy to those to whom you render service? Beloved, this is what God expects of us. And wherever we find ourselves, in whatever we do, be you a taxi driver, be you a farmer, be you a teacher, be you a soldier, wherever we find ourselves, at home, at work, even while moving along the streets, we can each effect this positive change that God expects of us. The prophet Micah, therefore, is addressing us. Let us be God's hands and God's feet. Let us bring this positive change, beginning with ourselves and then spreading it out to others. Through the intercession of St. Lawrence of Brindisi, let us beg God for that grace. St. Lawrence was born in Brindisi, that is in southern Italy, in the year 1559. He put his many gifts and talents at the service of Christ. He joined the Capuchins, and as an outstanding preacher, he spoke many languages. He traveled all over Europe to preach and strengthen the Christian faith. He was chosen to fill positions of leadership in his order, and he died in Portugal in the year 1619. In his own little way, wherever he found himself, Lawrence tried to shepherd the people as God would want of him. The same with us, dear friends. Wherever we find ourselves, let us be God's hands and God's feet. Let us shepherd his people and lead them to their own Bashan and Gilead, to exercise patience and love, and to welcome all. Amen. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come on you and remain with you forever. Amen.